Well, it's wonderful to have Tip O'Neill's son, Tommy O'Neill, here tonight. And he's going to speak now on behalf of the O'Neill family. So, Tommy O'Neill, please.
Mara, thank you. Thank you very, very much. To all of the O'Neill family that came and joined us here in Inishowen, near and far, and from the United States, let me simply say it's great to be with you as a family. To all of our friends that came from Boston to celebrate Therese Murray and her receiving of the third Tip O'Neill Diaspora Award, let us welcome you as new friends to Donegal. My dad had three heroes. One a Republican, an American Republican by the name of Abraham Lincoln. The second was the first man in the history of the United States, a Democrat, to run for the presidency, a Catholic, Al Smith. The third was a man 25 years his junior. His name is John Hume. I don't know how many things have been named after Tip O'Neill. We've got everything from golf courses to matchbook covers to forests to graveyards to golf courses, as I said. Two things stand out for the entire O'Neill family. Both have been celebrated today. One was the dedication of a ceremony over in his hometown, his great grandmother's hometown, where she once went to school, and they built a brand new heritage center with a name set aside is the Tip O'Neill Suite. 5 miles from where his great-grandmother was born and raised, on the same site where she went to school. The second was the Diaspora Award, because it holds such a very special thing. There would be a Diaspora Award, but it wouldn't be in my dad's name if it weren't for John Hume. Because the second ceremony had to do with the Chair for Peace over at McGee College, University, Ulster, in John Hume and Tip O'Neill's name. Those two things, singularly, would have been the most important things in my dad's life. You know, he did coin the expression, all politics is local. And boy, is it ever. There are many people who are not quite on the stage and people who are on the stage. John Hume is one. John Sweeney behind me, who was the capstone in the financing of the scholarship for the Hume O'Neill Chair, is another. Michael D. Higgins coins himself as a poet and a lecturer. Third in a series of Irish presidents to break from the tradition of celebrated office and one held for simple ceremony, stand out in the American and international stage to talk the things about peace, equity, and civil rights. Therese Murray. Therese Murray is special not because of her political narrative. What you don't know is about her personal story. This woman, like Michael D., John Sweeney, John Hume, and Tip O'Neill, has made herself to be an important leader. She's celebrated for making sure that she receives this award in recognition of the fact that she has helped Ireland in economic rediscovery and development. She's not only a great leader in our state legislature back in Massachusetts, but she legitimately cares about the American, Irish, and the international Irish condition. We celebrate you, Therese, in this fine tradition of the people who will be here celebrating with you this evening. Thanks for being with us. Enjoy yourselves, each and every one of you, and thanks for coming tonight.